Hello, welcome in chemical education. In this video, we are going to see the experimental work related to the colorimeter to determine the concentration of copper sulfate by using the colorimeter. Now in this experiment, the title of the experiment is to determination of lambda max and concentration of given solution of copper sulfate ammonia complex by colorimeter. Before the starting this experiment, we have to learn or revise the some photo laws. Now this is the cuvette cell and it contain the colored transparent solution. According to the photo law, when intensity of incident light is falls on the color crystal solution, that is transparent medium, then the some part of the light get reflected, some part of the light get transmitted, some part of the light get absorbed, and the some part of the light get scattered. Therefore, when a monochromatic light allowed to pass through the crystal color clear solution, then intensity of incident light is equal to the intensity of the absorbed light plus intensity of the reflected light plus intensity of the transmitted light plus intensity of the scattered light. Now some of the light pass through the solution, it is a transmitted light. Some part of the light get absorbed, it is absorbed light. Some part of the light get reflected, some part of the light get scattered. Now with this, the photo laws, the two laws are most important, that is the Lambert's law, Beer's law, and its combined law. Now, according to the Lambert's law, when a monochromatic beam of light is allowed to pass through the transparent medium, the rate of decrease of intensity with the thickness of the medium is directly proportional to the intensity of incident light. And therefore, according to Lambert's law, the absorbance is equal to A into B, where A is the absorptivity and B is the thickness of the cell. According to Beer's law, when a monochromatic light or beam is allowed to pass through the transparent medium, the rate of decrease of intensity with the concentration of the medium is directly proportional to the intensity of incident light. According to the Beer's law, A is equal to AC, where C is the concentration. And by combining these two laws, that is, the light is allowed to pass through the transparent medium, the rate of decrease of intensity with the thickness and concentration of medium is directly proportional to the intensity of incident light. And therefore, A is proportional to the B into C, where B is the thickness of the tube or cell and C is the concentration of the solution. Now, therefore, the A is equal to epsilon BC, where epsilon is the molar absorptivity. Now, in colorimeter, if we see the instrumentation part, it contains the mirror, source, then lens, slit one, monochromator, slit two, then the cuvette place, that is cell, detector, and recorder. Now in this case, what happened? The polychromatic light get become a monochromatic by passing through the filter. This polychromatic light make parallel with the help of lens and allowed falls on the filter where or monochromator, where a single wavelength light get allowed to transfer towards the cell. And in the cuvette, light get absorbed and remaining light get transmitted or falls on the detector, and detector gives the response which is measured in the recorder. Now in this instrument, first what we have to do, first we have to place the blank solution in the cuvette and then allow to light falls on the detector. Whatever the light is there, it gives the absorbance equal to the zero. And when we replace this tube blank solution by the colored solution, then it is observed that the absorbance light get absorbed by the solution and we get the absorbance. Means transmitted light get decreased and it will convert into the absorbance. How much light get absorbed by the solution only, colored pigment, that can be measured in terms of absorbance. This is the function of colorimeter. Now this can be used for a determination of concentration of the unknown solution. Now, in this instrumental part, the first part, the mirror, then source, then convex lens, slit, we are not going in detail. But in case of the monochromator, there are a number of types of monochromators can be used, like simple absorption filter, then interference filter, then prism, that is a monochromator, or a grating. Such a type of monochromator can be used, and therefore we can use this monochromator. Our aim is to make the or to get the single wavelength light. Now, in case of the cuvette, now this is the test tube like cuvette, and another is the rectangular cuvette. Now, such a type of cuvettes are used. These are made from the quartz material. Now, in case of the detector, the simple detectors can be used in the colorimeter or in spectrophotometer, the phototube meter, phototube detector, photovoltaic cell detector, then scintillation counter detector. Such a type of detectors are used, but in simple colorimeter, the phototube or photovoltaic cell, these two detectors, and in case of the UV visible spectrophotometer, we can use the scintillation counter. Now, in case of this experiment, what we required? In case of the chemical, 0.01 molar copper sulfate solution, we have to require. Then another solution, that is a liquid ammonia and water. Now, these two solutions required for this instrumentation. In case of the equipment, we can use the colorimeter by any made by the any company, or maybe by the local company. Now, in this way, we required the volumetric flask, then test tube, that is a cuvette, and graduated pipette. Now, in case of the first procedure, first part, preparation of different concentration of 0.1 molar copper sulfate solution with the ammonia as a complex. Now, initially what happened, from the copper sulfate stock solution and liquid ammonia, now from these two, we have to prepare a 0.08 molar solution. It requires the 20 ml of copper sulfate solution. We have to add by with the help of the graduated pipette. Then we have to add 5 ml of liquid ammonia in the same volumetric flask and make it zero, make it the level, that is a 25 ml with the help of distilled water. Then second solution, 0.06 molar, it requires the 15 ml of 0.01 molar copper sulfate, 5 ml of liquid ammonia, and remaining water to make the 25 ml. For third solution, 0.04 molar, 10 ml copper sulfate solution, 5 ml liquid ammonia, and remaining water to get the 0.04 molar solution. Then the 0.02 molar solution, it required the 5 ml of copper sulfate, 5 ml of liquid ammonia, and remaining water. And for unknown solution, it is given at the time of experiment. It contains the copper sulfate solution. We have to add the liquid ammonia in which the 5 ml of liquid ammonia, and we have to make the 25 ml. And last volumetric flask, that is measured, prepared as a blank without any copper sulfate, 5 ml of liquid ammonia, and we have to make the 25 ml with the distilled water. These are the solutions prepared. After preparation of this solution, we have to shake well all these solutions and then keep for the measurement. In the second procedure, we have to use the colorimeter. Suppose this type of colorimeter we can use here. And in the colorimeter, these are the filters here. We have to write in the observation table how many filters are available, such as 400 nanometer, 470 nanometer, 500 nanometer, 530 nanometer, 620 nanometer, 660 nanometer, and 700 nanometer. These are the filters or monochromators available in this colorimeter. Now, we require the highest concentration, that is 0.08 normal molar solution of copper sulfate ammonia complex, and we require the blank. Now, first procedure is to determination of lambda max. Now, what is the procedure for this? Start instrument for 15 minutes before starting the experiment. Now, what happened? The detectors and all devices in the colorimeter, it requires the time of 5 to 6 minutes to warm up, and then it gives the steady result. And therefore, 15 minutes before we have to start the instrument, then select the lowest filter. Now here we select the 400 nanometer filter first here, then keep blank solution. We have to keep the blank solution into the test tube, this cuvette, and we have to place it into the place of the cuvette. Then keep blank solution in a cell and press absorbance button. Here two buttons are there, absorbance and transmittance. First we have to press the absorbance button, then light will be glown here for absorbance, and then after pressing the button of absorbance, press calibration button. Now after pressing this calibration button, immediately we observe that there is a zero result. Okay, and after that, then replace this blank solution with the solution of 0.008 molar solution of copper sulfate placed here, and we observe that once you place this, immediately what happened? We observe that there is an absorbance 0.01, and therefore we can write here 0.01 absorbance. Okay, in this way, we can for next repeat the same procedure for each filter. Then we have to select the 470 nanometer filter, and then same procedure, blank, we have to keep the blank, make the zero by calibration, and then replace with the help of the highest concentrated solution. And then we observed that these are the result. We observed that these are the absorbance measured by the solution for the each and every monochromator. Now from this result, we have to plot the graph, and after plotting the graph, plot the graph of lambda versus absorbance, and it is observed that this type of nature of the graph is observed. The highest peak, that is the lambda max, it is a 620 nanometer lambda max for copper sulfate ammonia complex. That means this wavelength light is absorbed maximum by the copper sulfate ammonia complex solution. Once you select the lambda max, then the second procedure, that is a measurement of absorbance for known and unknown solution, which are the prepared known concentration and unknown solution, which is given by the teacher. Now here the procedure part is like this. Now we know the lambda max, that is 620 nanometer. We have to fix here 620 nanometer, then keep the blank solution in the cell and press absorbance and calibration. Then it is observed that there is a zero reading, that means calibrated for the blank. Means whatever the light get absorbed by the glass tube, solution, distilled water, ammonia, all are neglected. It becomes zero, that is 100% transmittance. Then replaced by this, the taking the first solution, that is 0.08 normal solution, and place here, and then we have to measure the absorbance immediately. And it is observed that when you replace this, 0.022 absorbance on the display card. Then again, we have to replace this by the blank solution. Then again, keep calibrate, it makes zero. And then whatever the solution, that is second solution, we have to take second solution, 0.06 molar solution into the this plus the cuvette. And then we have to measure the absorbance. Every time we have to make the zero absorbance for the blank. And we observe that for all these and for unknown solution, it is observed that 0.13 absorbance. Now in this way, for 0.08 highest concentration, 0.22 absorbance. Then for second solution, 0.18 absorbance. For third solution, 0.14 absorbance. For 0.02, that is fourth solution, 0.1 absorbance. And for unknown solution, 0.13 absorbance. Now from this, at the same time, when you measure the absorbance, press the button on the percentage transmittance. Immediately what happened, we observed that after measuring the absorbance, press the button of transmittance, we can write here the displayed the transmittance for the first solution, transmittance of the second solution, like that. Okay, in this way, we have to measure the absorbance for the known concentration solution and for unknown concentration solution. Now, then we have to plot the graph. Two types of graphs are here. We can plot the graph concentration versus absorbance and another graph concentration versus transmittance. Now, it is observed that in the first graph, concentration versus absorbance, for each non-concentrated solution, we have to measure the absorbance and then we have to plot the graph. It is a straight line passing through the origin, and from the unknown, we know the value of the unknown absorbance, that is 0.13. From the absorbance, we have to extrapolate this line, and then this line at this position, what is the concentration on the graph? That is the concentration of unknown solution. It is observed that 0.0035 molar. Now, in this way, we can calculate the concentration of unknown solution with the help of this graph, as well as another graph, the concentration versus percentage transmittance. It is observed that it is a curve like this, and at this position, at the transmittance of the unknown solution, we can calculate the concentration of unknown solution. In this way, the concentration of unknown solution, we can prepare the standard solution, and then comparative with the comparison, we can plot the graph, and from that graph, calibration graph, we can calculate the concentration of unknown solution. Okay, and then finally, we can write the result of the experiment. First is lambda max of the copper sulfate ammonia complex solution. It is for this experiment, it is a 620 nanometer, and the concentration of unknown solution 0.0035 molar solution. Okay. Thank you.